Ready. We have a ziyara of Prophet Holy here, and we will perform Milad and Mawlid, inshallah, with our brother Sidi Anwar coming, Nasheed recited coming from Morocco. So, inviting you for that event. Assalamu alaikum wa
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة.
عليه توكلت وإليه أنيب
وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا نظير له ولا مثيل له شهادة موصلة إلى دار القرار وأشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله أرسله الله تعالى رحمة للعالمين صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأولاده وأزواجه وأصحابه وأتباعه وخلفائه الراشدين المرشدين المهديين من بعده ووزرائه الكاملين في عهده خصوصا منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجلي وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون اتقوا الله تعالى وأطيعوه إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه المنزل على نبيه المرسل أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الشيطان لكم عدو فاتخذوه عدوا إنما يدعو حزبه ليكونوا من أصحاب السعير الذين كفروا لهم عذاب شديد والذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لهم مغفرة وأجر كبير صدق الله العظيم وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم المؤمن يألف ويؤلف ولا خير في من لا يألف ولا يؤلف All believers, all مؤمنون الحمد لله رب العالمين أفضل الدعاء الحمد لله رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم has taught us the best of dua is to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be thankful for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's favor on us We were given iman. We were given faith. We have accepted Islam as our religion. We have accepted Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as our Lord. We have accepted Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as our Nabi, as our messenger, as our prophet. We have accepted Quran as our holy book. We have accepted Kaaba. As our direction, our qibla. We have believed in what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has brought. And we are trying our best to do what they ordered us to do. And we are trying our best to leave what they told us to leave. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to do that. Give us success to do that. Inshallah, we continue to be Muslims. We continue to be mu'mins. And we give our breath with shahada. We finish, we seal our seals. With أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم And that is the best that we can get out of this life. Let's not think that we are in this life to do something else. We are not in this life to work day and night, day and night, day and night and make money and buy a mansion and buy cars and have this and have that, that is not the goal of our life. The goal of our life is to come to this earth and know about our Creator. To teach our children of our Creator. To teach our children of our Prophet, our Messenger, our Savior, Rahmatan lil Alameen, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To put our forehead in sajda, that is the goal of our life. To acknowledge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's orders and obey Him. To acknowledge Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's orders and obey Him. To find about His sunnah and follow it. That is the goal of life, O mu'min, O Muslim. Your goal in this life is not to collect money and make built up IRAs and 401ks and retirement funds and I don't know what. Your God is not money. Money might be the God, gold might be the God of other people. That is not your God. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not looked at this dunya. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, this dunya is not worth a mosquito wing. Why do we bother with this dunya? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made necessities that we need. Yes, we acknowledge that. We need shelter, we need food, we need clothes. But don't go beyond that. Don't make room in your head, oh, how can I get a second house, a vacation home? Now everybody wants a vacation home. They're not happy with their home anymore. Rasulullah has said, let your dar contain you, be enough for you. Nowadays, everybody wants a second home. Not in America. Maybe a second home in this continent, but they want a third home in an island somewhere. So what do? They run like a hamster. You know the hamster wheel? And you generate energy by running on the hamster, and that energy transforms into money. And then you waste all your day, all your week, all your month, all your years in acquiring money, and then buying homes overseas, and buying this and buying that. And what happens at the end? Your inheritor takes it. Your children, your relatives, your cousins that you never even knew existed. They all come, oh, he was my cousin. I want my share. And what happened to you? You are in the grave looking back. Who took my money? Who took my wealth? Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not send you here to gather stones and rocks and land and dirt. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent you here, all human being, to know about Him, about the Creator. Al-ilmu billah, al-ma'rifatu billah. How do you know about your Lord? You don't imagine your Lord is this, your Lord is that. No. You listen to what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about our Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of heavens and earth. Nowadays people are making their own gods. They're making their own description of the divine. They say God should be like this, God is like that. It's not up to you and me. It's up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the messenger that He has sent at that time to tell people, who is He? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who knows about our Lord? That is the one that is a winner. That is the successful one. Success here and success over there. Inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it that opportunity to learn more about Him, about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are in this month, His holy month, the holy month of Milad of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Back where I come from, my ancestors and the rulers upon my ancestors used to stand up when the name of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was mentioned. They stand up ta'zim, and they stand up to show their highest respect to that one. Who's that one? That one, He saved you, oh human being. That one, He saved you and has given you Jannah. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his heart was all for you, to give you Jannah. He did everything to show human beings Jannah, the way to Jannah. He struggled. He struggled so much with his holy Sahaba, Sahaba Ikram and his Ahlul Bayt. They struggled to show people the way to Jannah. He was working for your success, for your happiness. He was happy that you were born, that He can lead you to Jannah. Why aren't we happy that He was born, that He saved us from the path of Jahannam? At least acknowledge that, oh human being. The ones that are against celebration and being happy that Rasulullah has honored this earth, has honored us with the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has come to save us and to show us Jannah. At least with that we should be happy. That is the fazl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fadlullahi wa rahmatuh. Huda al-Habib al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Huda al-Anbiya, Huda Allah. At least by that, by acknowledging that this one, this holy one, this honorable one, this one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself showed the highest respect to, He has ordered His angels to show their highest respect to. He ordered you, my angels, you human beings that have believed, and I am sending the best, the highest, the most honored blessings and prayers and respect to al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He has ordered us to send our highest respect to him. At least what we can do in this holy month is attend one mawlid. Why not? We need to learn about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the mawlid, when they read the milad, they read his history, his ancestry, his pure ancestry. They read about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted to him. So at least we can attend one function as that and show our honor and respect to the one that is saving us from the path of Jahannam. Jahannam. But who is showing you the path of Jahannam, all human being? Shaytan. Shaytan is showing us the path of Jahannam. And mashallah, so many human beings follow Shaytan. Follow him, they take him as a friend. They leave Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they follow Shaytan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling them, there is somebody that is hidden from your eyes, O human being, that you cannot see, but he is always on your back, in your ear, in your heart, telling you things. And these things are mostly pleasures of this life. The tricks of Shaitan is not that he wants you to commit a sin or commit this or that. No, there is more to that. He wants to show you what this world has for us pleasures. So you can go inside these pleasures and forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his zikr. Al-Mu'riduna ani Allah. These are Hizb al-Shaytan. The group of Shaytan are the ones that turn their backs from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They turn their backs from zikrullah. Al-Mushtaghiluna bighayri Allah. They deal with other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You tell them, come to pray. They say, we don't have time. You tell them, please fast. I can't. I'm taking tests. I have to eat. You tell them, give zakat. He says, no. I have to buy something for myself. Who is telling them that? Shaitan. They are busy with other things other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't have time for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't have time for the masjid. We don't have time for zikrullah. We don't have time for reading Quran Kareem. We don't have time for that. What do? We have one shift, two shifts, and mashallah, if they're strong enough, they do a third shift too. They sleep 3-4 hours and they work 20 hours a day. And what happens at the end? At the end, all their wurras, al-wurrath, kulluhum mujtami'un. All the inheritors are mashallah by the bedside of their father. Oh, please die so we can get this will looked at. No, that's what your children are looking for. Oh, human being. They're looking at the time that you drop dead, that they take the millions you have gathered. Don't be fooled by Shaitan and his whispering. This dunya did not stay for anybody. This dunya did not stay for emperors, let alone yourself. Did not stay for kings. Look at the kings of Europe, kings of Asia, kings of Africa, kings of America, emperors of Brazil or whatever. They had emperors everywhere. Kings everywhere, mansions everywhere. What happened to them? They're not even bones anymore. There are no bones left to be seen. Nobody knows them anymore. Nobody hears about them anymore. All the tyrants that came, killed people, took their money and died, who remembers them nowadays from hundreds of years ago? But Sahaba Ikram that left dunya, everybody remembers them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that did not want dunya, he only wanted akhirah and mawla. And more than that, he only wanted mawla. He is the one that is honored every day, 5 times a day, all over the world. Which king has that power? Which president has that power? What kind of money do you need for that? Look of the honor of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised his mention. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرًا. We have raised your remembrance. We have raised your name. We have raised your mention. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. With him, every time we say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, is not complete unless we say, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. In azan, every ashadu an la ilaha illallah has to be followed by ashadu anna Muhammadan rasulullah. What kind of honor is that? And humans do it for free. They do it with love. The muazzin, they call that azan with love. He's not paid by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's paid in another way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving him his ajr for mentioning the shahada, of course. But physical money is not coming. But still human beings love to mention in azan the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at the honor of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, no matter how much as you honor Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as much as our Lord is happy with us, as much as you show love to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as much our Lord is happy with us. Because He loved him. How cannot we love the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved? Of course we love them. We love all of them. Inshallah their love in our hearts continue. The love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his Ahlul Bayt, and Sahaba Ikram, and Awliya, and Salihin continue in the hearts of our children as well. Keep bringing them to the mahfals, keep bringing them to the mawlids, to the milas, to the nasheed, qasayid. Teach them the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is no salvation or safety. Nothing will rescue you on the Day of Judgment except Hubbul Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will rescue us on the Day of Judgment. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is narrated by Imam Bukhari and Muslim, has said, al-mar'u ma'a man ahab, that the human being, the person is with the one he loves. Whom do you love, O human being? Do you love your cars? You're gonna be with them. You love your money? You love your work? You love your position? What do you love, O human being? What is in your heart? Everybody can check. I've seen some instance where they say, we love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They're describing themselves as Habib of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, lover of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And at the bottom he says, I love cricket. Cricket is in the heart of that person. That cricket has to come out. Have that love of football, love of basketball, love of whatever it is has to come out. Your heart has to be pure. You have to have qalbun saleem. Saleem. Pure, clean, nothing in it except the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we have that love in our hearts, we will be with the ones we love. And that is hadith, that is a big rahmah for people. So many of us are not awliya, so many of us are not excellent people. We all sin, we all do mistakes. Starting with me, we all do mistakes, we all can say wrong things, we can all say we do bad things. But we repent and we say istighfar. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness. But we have the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our heart. And we are trying to make that love stronger. Why? Because we say if all of our actions fail, if all of our deeds fail, if everything else fails, we have the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he has said, oh my Lord, and your Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is as-sadiqul ameen. He is the truthful one. He has said, al-mar'u ma'a man ahab, oh our Lord, we love him. Regardless of what we have done, all the mistakes we have done, oh our Lord, excuse us, Rabbana la tu'akhidna in nasina aw akhta'na. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us in Holy Quran what to recite for him. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has ordered, recommended, aman al-rasul, these two ayah in Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, to be read after Isha. Try to read it. It is a dua. Oh, our Lord, forgive us, pardon us, don't excuse us if we have forgotten or have made a mistake. We say, oh, our Lord, we are full of mistakes. We are not prophets, we are not saints, we are people. But we have the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he has said, al-mar'u ma'a man ahab. The person is with the one whom he loves. Make us with him, under his banner, tahta liwa'i al-hamd. Inshallah, all of us can build that love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is a big door of mercy. Big door of mercy for all humanity. Some non-Muslims love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I have met some Christians, some Jewish, some non-Muslims that say, that one, Muhammad, that you call Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina, Sayyidul Mursaleen, Sayyidul Awwaleen wal Akhireen, the master of everybody. They say we respect him. We have love for him. He was a good one, regardless of what others say. Some of them, they have that love. If they have the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they have honored him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might, at the last moments in their life, give them iman. Never. Might guide them to the right path, and they might say, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before they die. Nobody knows. We might not say that before we die. It's not secure. They might. Therefore, on every human being, or every human being, you have to look at them that this is a potential Muslim. Every human being is a potential Muslim, is Ummatul Da'wah. We have accepted what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said on with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But still, the da'wah is directed at the ones that did not accept. Everybody that is born in this world is being invited to accept message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ أَرْسَلْنَاكَ لِلنَّاسِ كَافَةً, to all of them, everybody. We have sent you to everybody, oh my beloved, ya Sayyidi, ya Rasulullah. We have sent you to everybody. So everybody is a potential Muslim. All Muslim, all mu'min in this hall, in this masjid, in this blessed place. Look at everybody as a potential Muslim. Don't look at them as a Buddhist, as a Hindu, as a Christian, as a this and that. No. Look at them. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He granted Iman and Islam to me, He might give that one also Iman and Islam. You never know. 1 month from now, 1 year from now, that one that you have taken as an enemy becomes your friend. عَسَى اللَّهُ أَنْ يَجْعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَهُمْ مَوَدَّةً. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might make in the future, if He guides them to Iman, they become your brothers in Islam, your sisters in Islam. Everybody is a potential Muslim. When you look at that person as a potential Muslim, you have surrounded yourself, you have made yourself in Jannah. You don't have any more enmity to anybody. You don't intend bad intention to anybody. That one is a servant of my Lord. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's wisdom has made him the way he is now. Or made her the way she is now. And in the future, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's wisdom, he knows the future, he knows the ghaib. Maybe she will become a Muslim or he will become a Muslim. Then you can accept everybody around you. When you accept everybody around you, you have made yourself in Jannah on earth. But when you don't accept everybody around you, what happens? You have made yourself live among thorns. Thorns. So which is better? To have khuluq, to have good manners and accept everybody is better, or to have bad manners and reject everybody and have hatred against everybody and have jealousy against everybody? Which is better? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in Holy Quran that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was innaka la'ala khuluqin azeem. You have such great, excellent manners. Why can't we be like him? Why can't we follow his sunnah and learn from Sahaba ikram, from tabi'in, tabi'a tabi'in, learn from awliya Allah, from as-salihin? Why don't we learn how to be good ones? They are a'imma. Nowadays, people, they say, oh, they are out of Islam. No. Ahlul Turuq are not out of Islam. These are the ones that have taught khuluqun azeem. They have taught how to become a good one, a perfect one, a pure one. They are mashayikh, they are ulama, they have done their best to bring up good Muslims. Good Muslim is the one that yasa'. As Rasulullah has said, al-mu'minu ya'laf wa yu'laf. Al-mu'min has ulfat, has ulfa. That means he is close to people. He can be intimate to people. He can be friends with people. He can be friendly with people. And people see him friendly too. They are friends with him. Al-mu'min is not the one that takes non-Muslims as enemies. Ya'laf wa yu'laf. And there's no khair in the one that has no ulfat, the one that is not beloved or befriended. Don't go with the ones that have hatred to others. That is not the way. The way is to go with the one that have love to others. And that was Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He had love for everybody. Because he is rahmatan lil alameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is rahmah? Rahmah is al-ataf, al-in'itaf. Isal al-khair. Rahmah is compassion, caring. You have to have love for that. If Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was رحمة للعالمين. That means he had love in his heart for everybody. Not only humans, for all creation, عالمين, everything. That's what we need to be. And that's how awliyaullah and the salihin were. They had love for everybody. They contained everybody. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us on the path of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On as-sirat al-mustaqim. Ya Rabbi, Ya Allah, in this holy day we are asking you, Ya Rabbi, to make us from the ones that follow his sunnah, Ya Rabbi. That love him and love his Ahlul Bayt and Sahaba-i Kiram wa-Salihin. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم وللمؤمنين فاستغفروه فيا فوزا للمستغفرين استغفر الله. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة شأن صفيه فقال عز وجل من قائل مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد لله أمته عن دار الجحيم مفخر العرب والعجم مولانا ومولى العالمين المحترمين سيدنا أبي القاسم محمد يا أيها المشتاقون نور جماله والمحتاجون شفاعته صلوا عليه صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعلي كلمة الحق والموحدين اللهم اجعل لنا من لدنك وليا اللهم اجعل لنا من لدنك سلطانا نصيرا اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات وتابع بيننا وبينهم بالخيرات رب اغفر وارحم وأنت خير الراحمين اللهم اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا إنك رؤوف رحيم اللهم ربنا اشفنا واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحمنا وارحم أمواتنا وأموات المسلمين اللهم لا تدع في مجلسنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا عيبا إلا سترته ولا ضرا إلا كشفته ولا حاجة هي لك فيها رضا وفيها صلاحنا إلا يسرتها يا أرحم الراحمين وصل يا ربي وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد الأشرف المرسلين وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وصحبه الكرام البرر أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة.